Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 6.14 that is taken from chapter number 6, Bending, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is the member having a rectangular cross section in figure 6-28 is designed to resist a moment of 40 Newton into meter. In order to increase its strength and rigidity, it is proposed that two small ribs be added at its bottom in figure 6-28b. Determine the maximum normal stress in member for both cases. So you can see this is figure 6-28 in which there is a rectangular cross section and that is used to resist movement of 40 Newton into meter. And in order to increase its strength and rigidity, two small ribs, these are the small ribs which are added to this rectangular cross section in order to increase its strength and rigidity. So you have to determine the normal stress in member for both cases. So we will find the maximum normal stress for this case A and maximum normal stress for this portion B. So let's start with the solution. First, what we will do is that for case A, that is without rib. So without ribs, we will take this figure A, clear? So without, we know that maximum normal stress is equal to moment multiply by C. C is the maximum distance from neutral axis divided by I, clear? So we will find this moment of inertia I. So how we will find this I? So as we know that moment of inertia for rectangular cross section is equal to 1 over 12 base time height cube. As you can see that if you take the mid of this vertical line, clear, and the mid of the horizontal line, so it will coincide at this point and this point will be centroid and neutral axis passing through this centroid and the moment is 40 Newton into meter. So its breadth is 60 millimeter and height is 30 millimeter. So I can write this 1 over 12 base is 60 and 60 is equal to in meter it is 0.060 meter and height is 30 millimeter. So in meter it is 0.030 meter and we will take the cube. So when you solve this, you will get moment of inertia will be equal to 0.135 into 10 raised to power minus 6 meter power 4. Now you have this I and you can see C is the maximum distance from neutral axis till top. Since both top and bottom are at the same distance, that is equal to, you can see 30 divided by 2. So this distance or this distance, both are equal to 15 millimeter and that is 30 divided by 2. So C is equal to, I can write 15 millimeter, which is 0.015 meter. Now you have each and every value, so you can just plug it in this. So you will get maximum normal stress is equal to moment. Moment is 40 Newton into meter and C is equal to 0.015 meter divided by I is 0.315 into 10 raised to power minus 6 into 6 meter power 4. So when you solve this, if I want to write the unit, so you can see the unit of 40 is Newton into meter multiplied by C, unit is meter divided by meter power 4. So you will get the answer is equal to 4.44 into 10 raised to power 6 Newton per square meter. And in mega, you can also write it 4.44 into 10 raised to power 6 Newton per meter is Pascal. So in mega Pascal, it is 4.44 mega Pascal. So this is the value of maximum normal stress for rectangular cross section shown in figure A, that is without ribs. Now what we will do is that for with ribs, as you can see, two small ribs are added at the bottom. So what I will write is with ribs, that is figure B. So as you can see that two small these ribs are added at the bottom. So if I take the mid of this, it will be not symmetrical about. So its centroid or neutral axis will be not at the mid of this 30 millimeter. So what we will do is that first we will find the centroid or the location of neutral axis. That can be obtained by using this formula. Y bar is equal to sum of y dash into a divided by sum of area. And what we will do is that you can write it as, if you take this whole rectangle as one unit, this whole rectangle without rib is one, clear? So its area is how much? Its area will be equal to 30 multiplied by this total length, which is equal to 10, 10, 10, 10, 40, 50 and 60, clear? So its area, let this rectangle which I have drawn as blue is taken as 1, and this we will find, we can write this formula is y dash 1. So y dash 1 into a 1 plus, you can see there are two small ribs at the bottom, both are same dimension, and we called it as 2. So we can write this formula as plus 2 times y2 dash into a2 divided by sum of area. So area for a1 is a1 and 2 times a2. What is area a1? So we can write area a1 is 30 multiplied by total length. This length is 60 millimeter. So in meter it is 0.03 multiplied by 0.06, and the unit will be square meter, clear? And what is y1 dash? So y1 dash is distance from the reference line till the mid. So we will take this top surface as a reference line. So from reference line till the mid of this first section is this one, and this distance is 30 divided by 2. So this is y1 dash, and that is equal to 15 millimeter. So y1 dash is 15 millimeter or 0.015 meter. Now what is a2? So a2 is, you can see this small segment, so its height is 5 millimeter and width is 10 millimeter. You can see 10 millimeter. So I can write it, height is 5, so 0.005 meter into 10 millimeter, and 10 millimeter in meter is 0.10 meter. So it will also in be square. And what is y2 dash? So y2 dash bar. So y2 dash is distance. Let me zoom it. It will distance from the new, from this reference line. Clear? This is the reference line. So distance from reference line till the mid of this section A2. So this will be y2 dash. Okay. I will also unzoom it. Okay. So y2 dash is equal to this 30, and the half of 5 is 0.25. Clear? So that will be equal to 2.5 millimeter. So 32.5 millimeter. Okay. And this 32.5 will be equal to 0.0325 meter. Now you have all the values, just plug it in. Y1 dash is 0.015 meter into A1. A1 is 0.03 multiplied by 0.06 plus 2 times Y2 dash. Y2 dash is 0.0325 multiplied by area A2, which is 0.005 multiplied by 0.01. divide by sum of areas. So sum of areas is area A1 is 0.03 multiplied by 0.06 plus 2 times the area of A2, which is 0.005 multiplied by 0.010. Okay. So when you solve this, you will get this y dash bar, and this y dash bar comes out to be 0.01592 meter, or you can say that this y bar is equal to 15.92 millimeter. Okay, so what we will do is that we will represent this on element. So I will represent it by using red color. So 15.92 from the top, neutral axis lies 15.9 millimeter from the top. So mid of 15, so your neutral axis or centroidal axis will be somewhere here. So this distance is y dash bar, and that is equal to 15.92 millimeter. Okay, now you have this. You can see that what is CC is the maximum distance from neutral axis. It will be either top or bottom. So you can see this is total is 35 from this till this. This is 35, and from this centroidal axis till top, it is 15.92. Clear? So C will be equal, maximum distance will be this one. You can see if you subtract 35 minus 15.92 will give you 19.08 millimeter. This will be equal to C. Clear? You can see the upper distance from the centroidal axis is 15.92 and lower distance remaining is 19.02, which is C. C is the maximum distance from neutral axis. And for without ribs, also we know that maximum normal stress or bending stress is equal to M into C divided by I. So here we have moment, we have C. What is I? And this I will be no more like we did in rectangular portion without ribs. You can see that this centroidal axis is about centroidal axis, it is not symmetrical. So what we will do, we will apply parallel axis theorem. So I will write by using parallel axis theorem for portion 1. This is 1. So we can see that it will be equal to 1 over 12 BH cube. B is 60, so 0.060, and height is 30 millimeter. So we can write in meter is 0.030. Since this centroidal axis or neutral axis away from the center of this rectangular section by this distance, this is D. Clear? So we will write AD square. So area is 0.060 and multiply by 0.030 in D square. What is D? So D is distance from neutral axis till the mid of first section. So this is the distance. And how we can find this? So we know that this distance is 15.92 and this distance is 15. So 15.92 minus 15 will be equal to 0.92 millimeter. Clear? And 0.92, we can also write it y dash is 15.92 millimeter. So in meter it is 0.01592 minus y dash is 15 millimeter. So in meter it is 0.015 meter. So this is D, AD square. So I can write it 1 over 12 BH cube plus AD square. So for 1, 1, 1, 1, that is equal to I plus for 2 portion, it will be equal to 2 times 1 over 12 B2H2 cube plus A2 into D2 square. Clear? Okay. Now, what is, I will write it here, plus 2 times 1 over 12. What is breadth of this web? So breadth is 10 millimeter. You can see 10 millimeter and height is 5. So 1 over 12, 10 millimeter is the breadth, which is 0.01. Clear? And height is 5 millimeter, so 0.005 meter whole cube, plus area A2, which is 0.01 multiplied by 0.005, clear? And D square, what about D square? D2, so D2 is distance from this neutral axis till the mid of second section, clear? So how you can find that? You can find it by using, you can see this distance was this distance. This distance was from the top till the mid of section. This was y2 dash, which is 32.5, clear? So if you subtract this distance, 15.92, from this 32.5, so you will get this distance. Distance from this neutral axis till the mid of second section. So 32.5 minus 15.92. So 32.5 is actually 0.0325 meter minus 15.92 is 0.01592, and it is D square. So there will be square. So when you solve this, you will get I will be equal to 0.1642 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter power 4. Now you have all the values, just plug it in this formula. Sigma max is equal to moment, which is 40 newton into meter. C is this one, 19.08. So in meter, it is equal to 0.01908 meter. Divide by I is 0.1642 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter power 4. So simplify it, you will get 4.65 into 10 raised to the power 6 newton per square meter, or that will be equal to 4.65 into 10 raised to the power 6 pascal, and in megapascal 4.65 megapascal. So this is the maximum normal stress when we add two small ribs at the bottom of rectangular section. So in this way, we have found this is the maximum stress without ribs, and this is the maximum stress with ribs. And you can see that if we add ribs, so maximum stress is increasing, but we do not want to increase the stress in the section. So what will be the conclusion? Conclusion is that, let me write it. Conclusion is that this surprising result indicates that the addition of ribs to the cross section will increase the maximum normal stress rather than decrease it. Also, it is increasing the strength, but here the maximum normal stress in the beam is increase, clear? So, and for this reason, they should be omitted. So preferred design for this beam that resists 40 newton into meter will be this one. And that was all about this problem 6.14. This was made by on request of one of the subscriber who insisted me to explain this problem. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.